We are discussing the chapter 3, pair of linear equation in two variables of class 10 mathematics. Now see the elimination method. What is elimination method? We will try to remove one variable. When we can remove one variable, we can find out the value of the second variable. And when it is used, all the methods being shown here or presented here, you will use the method which is most convenient to you. For example, if the ratio of income of 2% is 9 and 7. So, if 1 is 9x, 7 is, the second is 7x. The expenditure is 4 is to 3. That is 4y, 3y. This is the ratio. Now, the saving is 2000 per month of both these guys. So, 9x minus 4y equal to 2000 and 7x minus 3y equal to 2000. So, this is the equation we are going to make. So, what we can do here is, we can multiply this equation by 4. This equation by 3. Why I multiplied it? Because both of these values will become 12y and we can easily eliminate it. And this is the process, elimination. So we can just subtract them. This is eliminated. You can find x. You can place x in any of this equation, any of this equation, and then you can get the value of y. You can also verify it, that is 9x, 7x, and x and y you have got. So 4y, 3y, and then you can find out the differences also. That will be 2000. So how you are going to do this? You have to multiply the values, or we'll see one more example. You have to multiply accordingly such that one x or either y, either x or y gets cancelled, or they become numerically equal so that you can just cancel them out. And then you can find out if x is cancelled, you can find out y. If y is cancelled, you can find out x. And then you can, of course, after finding out the value, the original equation can be used to put the value again and you can get the answer. So we'll take one more example, 2x plus 3y equal to 8 and 4x plus 6y equal to 7. So it is quite easy because we are aware that if I multiply this equation by 2, this will become 6y and we can eliminate this 6y. So we have multiplied this equation, first equation by 2, and now we can just eliminate it. So this is eliminated and you can see 0 equal to 9, and we know that when this kind of things comes, which is actually false, we have no solutions. There are no solutions. Now, the sum of two digit number and the number obtained by reversing the digit is 66. So, how to represent the two digit number first of all? See, if this is 56, how I can write 56? I can write it 50 plus 6. How can I write 50? 5 into 10 plus 6. So, if this is x, this is y, this is x into 10 plus y. So 10x plus y. So this is how we represent the two digit number. How about 10y plus x? Because they have also said reversing. So 56 will become what? 56 will become 65. This is equal to 60 plus 5. That is 6 into 10 plus 5. So this will be y into 10 plus x. So 10y plus x. Right? So the addition of these two, the number and the reverse number, is 66. They have told this in the question. So 10x plus y plus 10y plus x equal to 66. So this is the one equation. X plus y equal to 6. X plus y equal to 6. Now the second equation is quite simple. The digit differ by 2. So it can be x minus y equal to 2. It can be y minus x equal to 2. So both possibilities are there. So we'll use both equations. So now this x plus y equal to 6, x minus y equal to 6, we can just easily solve this because we have y which can be cancelled. So 2x will be equal to what? 2x will be equal to x, this 8. So x will be 4 and y will be 2. And you can also use this with this. We have used these two first, now we'll use these two. So y minus x equal to 2, and after solving this we get x equal to 2 and y equal to 4. So the number first, in the first case, becomes 42. The second case becomes 24, and you see the difference of both these two are 2 only. Now cross multiplication method. How to solve the cross multiplication method? Sometimes it becomes very difficult to solve the equation by graphical substitution and elimination method. For that we have another solution, which is the cross multiplication method. We'll start with an example. We have 5 oranges, say 5x. We have 3 apples, say 3y. So the sum is 35. So 5x plus 3y equal to 35. This is our first equation. Then 2 oranges means 2x plus 4 into apple means y. 2x plus 4y equal to 28. So 2x plus 4y equal to 28. So we'll place it here. Place it here means rearrange them. We'll try to find out, rearrange such that right side becomes 0. So these are two equations. Now how to solve them? The best way, we have already seen that, multiply the first equation by 4, second equation by 3, and then we'll have a easy sort of thing, because y gets eliminated. So what will be x? X will be this number by this number. So this is your x, and easily when you are aware of x, you can find out the y. So let us formally define it. If these two are equation, a1x plus b1y plus c, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, x will be this b1c2 minus b2c1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1. See, these, the denominators are same. Y for y, it will be c1 a2 minus c2 a1 by this. So just place the value and you see x and y will be these values. So how to remember this? We'll just see. There's a proper way of learning it also. So these two are equation. What we have done is, we have multiplied this by b2, we have multiplied this by b1, and then we try to eliminate this b. And then when we eliminate it, we place this value, which we call just here x, in any of this equation or any of these two equations. This equation. So we can place this value in 1 or 2, we can get the value of y. And you see, this should not be 0. If this is not equal to 0, then only you get the unique solution. And then, if second case, if this is 0, then what you can do? A1 by A2, A B1 by B2, because the ratio, because these two are not equal, they are actually equal. So if they are equal, let us make it k. So a1 will be k a2, b1 will be equal to k b2. Let us substitute in our equation 1, and you have already known the equation 1, right? This is our equation 1. We are placing it here. So let us place this in equation number 1. This will be k, then bracket a2x plus b2y plus c1. And we observed from the second equation in the cell that c1 equal to kc2 by this. So c1 by c2 equal to k. So we say, we find that a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, c1 by c2. If we get this, then it will have a infinite many solution. Don't learn or try to just remember these things, because we are going to find out exactly what it means. So the things which I want to summarize here is that if a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2 in these two equations, we get a unique solution. If these ratios are exactly similar, then they are infinitely many solutions. If these two are similar, but it is, they are not similar to c1 by c2, there are no solution. We have already seen this in the previous discussion. So how you are going to get the solution by elimination method? It will be x by b1 c2 minus b2 c1, y by c1 a2 minus c2 a1, 1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1. So you have to find out x, just place it here, find out. You have to find out y, just take it here and find out. So what you get here is, see, this is b1, how to remember? For finding x, you have to do b1, c2. You have to write b1, b2, c1, c2, a1, a2, and again b1, b2. For finding x, you have to do b1, c2 minus b2, c1. For finding y, you have to do c1, a2 minus c2, a1. And for in the denominator of 1 will be a1, b2 minus a2, b1. This is how you get it. We'll take an example, then try to solve it. See, you are in Bangalore. Now, you can go to Malleshwaram and you can go to Yashwantpur. So if you buy two tickets to Malleshwaram and three tickets to Yashwantpur, so two to Malleshwaram, three to Yashwantpur, the cost is 46. So let us assume this is x, this is y. So 2x plus 3y equal to 46. So 2x plus 3y equal to 46. Now, if we buy three tickets to Malleshwaram and five tickets to Yashwantpur, so 3x plus 5y is equal to 74. This is our second equation. Just transfer 46 on the left side, transfer 74 on the left side. So we have this equation, a1x1 plus a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. And you know how to solve it. We have just seen. So we place x, y1, try this, right? And then just place it below x, y, and 1. So x can be found out by taking this numerator, taking this denominator. Y can be found out by taking this numerator and this denominator. So x and y you have got. Again, we have one more example. 4x plus py plus 8 equal to 0. 2x plus 2y plus 2 equal to 0. You have to find out the value of p. for which this equation has a unique value. Well, this will have a unique value when a1 by a2 will not be equal to b1 by b2. Let us take this is a1, this is b1, this is a2, this is b2. So 4 by 2 is not equal to p by 2, cancel it out, p not equal to 4. So except 4, because p cannot be equal to 4, all other equation or all other pair of equation, you cannot have 4 here. Otherwise, all pairs or all values of this pair x and y, this is going to give you a unique solution, only except 4. Now, for what value of k will the following pair of equation have infinitely many solutions? You know, infinite, a1 by a2 has to be equal to b1 by b2, c1 by c2. This is a1, this is b1, this is c1. a1, a2, b2, c2. Place it here. So you get, by first you get this one, by second you get this one. So by first solving this, k square will be equal to 36, so k can be equal to plus 6 and minus 6. How about solving this two? You get k equal to 0 or 6. So combining this, you take plus 6 as the answer. K is equal to 6. When k is equal to 6, you get infinitely many solutions. Now we have onto those equations which can be reduced to pair of linear equation in two variables. So these are not actually pair of linear equation, but they can be reduced. For example, if you have 2 by x, 3 by y equal to 13, 5 by x minus 4 by y equal to minus 2. This 1 by x you can take it separately. 1 by y you can say take separately. Okay, in this case also. So this 1 by x can be taken as say some p, this can be taken as q, this again p, q. So now you can write it as 2p plus 3q, 5p minus 4q equal to minus 2 and 13. You can easily solve this, you know by now how to solve it, you can use any method. So p equal to 2, q equal to 3. But p was taken as 1 by x, so you have to place 1 by x equal to 2, because p is 1 by x. Q is equal to 1 by 2, 1 by y, that is 3. 3 is 1 by y, so y is equal to 1 by 3. So this is how you get the x and y value. One more example we'll take. We have to solve this equation by reducing them to a pair of linear equation. This 1 by x minus 1 can be taken as p. 1 by y minus 2 can be taken as q, because they are here also. So this 5p plus q equal to 2. 6p minus 3q equal to 1. Now these two are linear equations. In two variable, now you can solve p is equal to 1 by 3, q equal to 1 by 3. But we have taken 1 by x minus 1 equal to 1 by 3. So you have to solve for x. Now again 1 by y minus 2 equal to 1 by 3, you can solve for y. So x equal to 5, y equal to, x equal to 4, y equal to 5. One more example is that a boat goes 30 km upstream. See, if this is a river and this is flowing like this. So when you are downstream, this river is actually helping you. While you are going upstream, this river is actually not helping you, but resisting you, because it is you are trying to force or go on the other direction. So if the speed of boat in still water is x, and stream and the speed of stream is y, so while you go on this side, this will be x plus y, because it is going to benefit you. While you go on that side, it is going to resist you, so this will be x minus y. So the speed of boat will be x plus y downstream, x minus y boat upstream. Now you know this equation, time is equal to distance by speed. The question given here is 30 km upstream and 44 km downstream takes 10 hours. So first we'll take 30 and 44. So 30 by x minus y, this is the upstream speed. So let us take time as t1. And 44 downstream, let us take x plus y, because it is going downstream. Let us take it as a t2. So t1 plus t2 is given as 10. The addition of the time is given as 10 for these two. So we have taken the first one, we have taken the second one, and we have just added. So these two added is 10. In a similar fashion, the question says that 40 km upstream, 55 km downstream gives you 30 knots, or it takes 30 knots. So this will be 40 by x minus y plus 55 by x plus y by using time equal to distance by speed. Will be 30. Now here, these two are equations. 1 by x minus y you can take as u, 1 by x plus y you can take as v. So these two equations will become 30u plus 44v equal to 10. 40u plus 55v equal to 30. Take 10 here, take 13 here. Solve that by cross multiplication method. You get u and v like this. Now, 1 by x minus y was taken as 1 by 5. 1 by x plus 5 was taken as 1 by 11. So, x minus y equal to 5, x plus y equal to 11. Now, these two are again the linear equation of two variables. Now, you can easily solve them because you just have to, because you can easily solve by elimination because these two will get cancelled out. So, 2x will be 16, x will be 8, and y also you can find out. So, the speed of boat in still water is 8 km per hour and speed of stream is 3 km per hour. So, what we have summarized, what we have learned, let us summarize it, that two linear equation in the same two variables, they are called as pair of linear equation in two variables. And the general form is like this: a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. This cannot be 0, you know. If this becomes 0, this will not be a linear equation in two variables. If you want to solve them, there are two methods: graphical and algebraic method. You can use graphical method if line intersect, solution is consistent. If line coincide, you say they are dependent or consistent. Infinite magnitude solution. If the line never intersect, we say they have no solution, so they are inconsistent. When you go to algebraic methods, you can use substitution, elimination, and cross multiplication. So this is how you try to find out whether they are consistent, inconsistent, and dependent and consistent. If these two are equation, a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, then we say that the pair of linear equations are consistent. If a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, but they are not equal to c1 by c2, these pair of linear equations are inconsistent. If a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2 are equal, we say the linear equations are dependent and consistent. So there are various ways, applications where this can be used. So this is all about your pair of linear equation in two variable. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.